Hello, welcome to patch 1.5. Now I wanted to test out the Terminator in a skirmish battle because that's what people love to see, but sadly we have three problems. Problem number one is that there are not a lot of servers currently. And as you can see, well, let's switch worldwide. Sometimes you can find more, sometimes you can find less, sometimes the ping is good, sometimes the ping is bad. I mean, yeah, you have to play basically in the entire world, otherwise you'll not find a lot of games. Also, if you choose to start in an already started game, that will be easier, but there is a big problem. By the way, this is the new interface, I love it. The Terminator class is limited by one only. So only one Terminator squad per... one Terminator per squad. So you can make a squad out of assaults, which is a fun idea. You can only have max, let's say, 3 heavies or 3 medics. But only one Terminator, so I don't know why they would limit this class like this. Well, I think it's because the Terminator class on itself is very strong. But if you play, let's say, with 2 or 3 Terminators, it can either get too strong or too weak. So yeah, I think that's one of the reasons they made it like that. Or maybe they just... I don't know. I think people will be very angry about this one. And you can also see all of the settings over here. Artillery, none, secondary missions, many, arrival early, air support heavy. So everything you need to except for the how much experience you get. 140, 150, 110. Yeah, they should also mention over here, or maybe over here, how much percentage experience you get. Yeah, so not a lot of games. The Terminator is limited to one per squad. Also, if you remember, you have... sorry about this. You have to unlock the class itself. Which is 6 points. If you already are working with the autocannon. Otherwise, well, it will be a lot harder to unlock the Terminator. Another problem is that even if you unlock the class, even if you find a game without a Terminator in it on a server that has a good ping, well, you have to buy all of the components as well. Well, I guess the most interesting ones are not even interesting, because look at this. Cooldown 80 seconds and you only give your friends a few energy bullets. I guess this is very good in case you find a boss that is very weak to energy damage. That will be super helpful. And that's another teleport, so you can basically skip the last two, but you will need a lot of these ones over here. So yeah, I don't have a lot of points, so we'll have to play in the campaign with him. Just before the end, so my campaign will be super aggressive and super hard. So to unlock the Terminator in the campaign, you need advanced power cores. I also like the description. Terminator troopers are the pinnacle of mankind's warfare industry. They also seem to topple very often, so they end up on their backs if you kill the NPC Terminators in the campaign. Equally capable of aggressive assaults and firm defense stands, these fearsome units deploy in an experimental armor system. Only the most experienced senior officers can operate them, although the risk of catastrophic overheat is always present. Very weird choice of language, of sentences, of firm defensive stands. Of strong defensive capabilities, I don't know, they should have, okay. Ignore. Now this is, oh, they have a lot of other changes as well. Looks like for the minimum intel for this region. I guess this is related to the Black Ops mainly. Let's actually send Roland in this Black Ops over here. As you can see... okay, so if you know before the patch, if you loaded your game, the Black Ops would simply disappear. But now it looks like they put all of the Black Ops on default to be available for you to see. So if you put just Black Ops over here, deployment cost will be zero. I think you can deploy from other regions as well. And you also get the marker over here. And also, the minimum intel for this region will always be 1, well, except for now. So minus infestation grow on the left and also on the right. Yeah, that's a fun thing to see. Now let's go to the loadout. As you can see, the basically. Basically, the executor armor is the Terminator armor. And don't worry, I actually made the loadout before the video. I'm actually thinking of these things. So yeah, let's actually show all of the options. I'll show the options and then I'll show you what I chose, because otherwise it will take us forever. Force field. I didn't play before the video, so I don't really have a clue what these things do. But just based on the text. Dio Striker. Dio is God in another language. I don't know which one, but it's... yeah. Plasma Burst looks fun. Also Plasma Gun... okay. The funny thing is, if you use this skill, it actually has the shoulder-mounted plasma gun, so if you see in the patch notes, plasma gun is this one over here. It's a module. Just like the heavy. Weapon overload. Is this one of the new ones? Might be, I forgot. Nah, Night Swarm. This one looks interesting, but again, I'm just choosing skills that don't have such a big cooldown and only essential skills. Combat Exhaust. Did I show off this one? Agility Exhaust. Combat Exhaust. So yeah, also Dio Striker will produce energized stacks as the same as for the force field. And as for support, well, this is where things get interesting. Teleport. XIS. This also generates energized stacks. If the maximum energy stacks are exceeded, the operator will explode in the shape of a miniature nuclear bomb. Extreme care is recommended. Okay, I have no idea what that means, but looks like the Terminator has some problems. So in order to keep maybe trolling at the minimum, so they don't kill their own squad or stuff like that, maybe it's safer for everyone to only have one Terminator per squad. Plasma discharge. Yeah, this also might be a problem taunting all enemies. So this is really a tank. He's a tank and also a very good assault unit. This is the one I'll be using, energy capacitors. Because like everyone said in Red Solstice 1, only the Terminator could successfully use the Vindicator Surge. So he's also kind of like a team player. He can be a buffer, hold the last line or lead the assault. He can be many things. Exhaust. Energized charge, really? So this consumes energized stacks as well. Anyway, I'll just use the agility one and the combat one. Now let's see the loadout. As you can see, it's 610, perfectly distributed power system. So force field, agility exhaust, combat exhaust, Dio Striker, plasma gun module, and then energy capacitors. This will be a little weird to test it on this mission, because it will get very crazy very fast. So let's do it like that. Also, I need to run faster. I also want the suit power overcharge so I can test more things faster. Also, the power surge so I don't have to wander around the map too much. Yes, this will either be good or bad. Oh, wait a minute. I just have to check if the vaccines have the right tooltip. Well, they don't have the right tooltip, but they reduce infestation by one in the region after the mission. I'm not sure if the mission is lost, if you still get that minus one to infestation. Oh, he has a little thingy on his back. Like a little cape. Yeah, so this mission will get very, very crazy very soon, so don't think too much about it, especially because my bots have Reaper rifles. But again, I don't have any way to showcase the Terminator class right now. I don't have the points, like explained. Maybe later I'll make a proper build for him, but for now, this is the best build without testing it. Also, you might get killed very early, but it's all a toss of the coin. Sorry about the 10-minute introduction, but there were a lot of things I had to specify about the game and the classes and some other things related to the patch. Also, the ASV is changed. Well, I didn't show off the ASV. Well, you have a double shot mode and also the normal power mode. It's all kinetic damage.
Attention! This is the last group, but we are on the verge of being overrun.
We need support, man.
Sounds like things are about to get exciting around here. Hurry up and get to them.
Calibrating. Oh, they also changed this thing. So increase your combat capabilities. Marking location.
They have proper things for everything.
Calibrating communication array will increase your combat capabilities. Marking location.
Yeah, let's do that one first. So plasma gun module, I guess we should activate this one. Okay, oh, that's actually a lot of energy. He might need an extra energy. And he'll have to play with that thing.
My energy's too low.
So where are the energized stacks? Kind of weird, okay. He also has a lot of inventory slots, which is great. What does he say? Soldiers over there?
Take that. Search that locker. Open that locker.
Oh, that's nice. It looks very nice. Charging. So this actually has a very low cooldown. Now I'm wondering if we'll have enough energy to use it at will. Oh, we'll definitely have enough energy. What about the Dio Striker? How is it used? Oh, that's nasty. So you got the energy suit and the energy capacitor from the Dio Strike.
Not enough energy.
This class is overwhelming in the beginning. How do you keep track of all of this? So we have the by the way, the buffs are shown in blue. Oh, that's how. I guess we can still go nuclear. Oh, exactly the mission I needed. Okay, let's go into that one.
Biomass spread can be suppressed by engaging stroll mutants while on top of it.
So this will drain your energy. Marked. Energize suit, energy capacitor. I guess if you activate it with Dio Striker,
not enough energy.
It's a very weird class, to be honest. I expected it to be a little more understandable. Okay, let's suppress the biomass and then we'll do some other missions. So that will give me some extra damage? It doesn't seem like it will give me extra damage. So how does it work? Consume stacks. How do you get those stacks? Oh man, this is a great class, but I think people will have a hard time learning it. So from what I can tell, you can only get energy stacks from certain skills that you can
engaging.
Oh, it has a different sound. I like the way it sounds very powerful, but it uses up a lot of energy, apparently. What? 25 energy, this is a bad joke. The ASV is a bad joke, never using the ASV again. 25 energy, well I guess we have a lot of energy regeneration, but it's because of the... They made a very bad decision, this is a huge nerf to the ASV, now I can no longer use it. It doesn't make sense. Why would you use 25 energy for 600 kinetic damage? I mean, at this point, it's actually cheaper just to use a skill. Look at this, 50 energy, and it can do 4,000 damage each 20 seconds, which is basically... Oh, okay, wait. Okay, the cooldown for that is also lowered, which is nice. Yeah, they made a lot of questionable decisions. I mean, the ASV still is not bad, but remember, we have a lot of buffs from the thingy.
Hold position until further notice. Expect heavy resistance.
The class itself is not bad. I mean, it has everything you could ask for. Stat-wise, it's one of the better classes because, yeah, we have the inventory space. We have also the speed is also pretty good. The energy regeneration is also pretty amazing. What? Oh, it's above the ground, okay. So that's like a plasma grenade, but the sounds are very good for it.
Attacking.
So let's use this thing again, maybe we'll better understand it. For both the Terminator and the monster receiving the buff. 18%. Oh, it also has a minus to your. Okay.
Scans report the biomass started mass producing stroll creatures.
If you get 20,
however, it's
we have to stop killing creatures. So each time we kill something, we get an energy stack, but we have to stop killing, otherwise we'll detonate ourselves. Okay, that's pretty funny, considering what it does. Yeah, we have to be super careful, otherwise we'll get smashed. I mean, the whole squad might get smashed. A mini nuclear explosion, that sounds super bad. But I like the way this one is made. Because you basically have to get energized stacks and then you have to use them. I still don't understand how this increases the damage, passive weapon damage. Oh, he can only hold 12? That's kind of bad. So, I guess that's the downside to this class. He can only hold 20 magazines, this is because of my buffs. 20 magazine, 20 main gun, 20 primary weapon, ammunition, and 12 vindicator.
I would advise using them against
yeah,
the
that's
biomass.
A bit low. That's a bit low for what it's supposed to do. But I like this one a lot. And the ASV sounds great, but... That's just a lot of energy wasted. I don't think anyone will play with the ASV anymore, including me. There are much better options right now. The only the reason I like the SV was because of that piercing shot, but now I don't even like it because of that.
Here they come! We're in the sector, but we brought along a few new mutant friends.
Okay, let's show the force field a little more.
And for the love of Trinity, don't wander off.
So we got energized suit buffs if they touch the shield. Well. Okay, I kind of get what they're going for. So if you have too many charges, you have to use the energy capacitators or the plasma gun modules. So you get more stuff out of them.
Engaging.
Okay, so let's activate this Dio thing.
Attacking.
So I get stacks per kill right now.
Reloading. Cover me.
That was a bit dangerous. Yeah, but the stacks...
This cabin has extra armor.
The stacks disappear very fast. I'm not sure if this will actually be usable in combat that much. Yeah, this will be kind of like a more stationary class. Oh, now you can actually see the energy of your teammates. That's brilliant, come on. And, whoa, the boss are not affected by the red storm? Never? I didn't know about that. Okay, I guess we're learning a lot of new things in this thing, in this campaign. Okay, I guess I cannot be too upset about the changes because we're learning new things, and that's actually a very good change. Now you can see if that medic doesn't heal you because he's blind. So if the medic has energy and doesn't heal you, he's blind. So we have two skills that consume energy stacks and two other that produce the... I don't know. I don't think this is properly implemented in my opinion. Especially with the Dio Striker, because you get energy stacks, yes, and you do more damage to the enemy, but you also get a big debuff for yourself. And that doesn't last very long. Cooldown 46 seconds. And I guess when you're out of energy, it deactivates on its own. Attacking. Not enough engaging. Yeah, the shield as well, so... Terminating. Attacking. Okay, I can see not a lot of people will enjoy the Terminator, to be honest.
Attacking. Radar isn't picking anything up after this one.
Huh. So the max stacks will be 18 right now. What if I activate this without a... Okay, it doesn't do anything. I can see the convoy missions still have the same problems if enemies get behind the trucks. Engaging. I suppose these skills are unusable unless you have the energy stack, so that makes them a lot less useful than you might think, because nothing on this character is used on demand. Most of the things are used per energy stacks. And this would be a problem, I mean. You'll need a lot of... what are the power nodes? Not power nodes, what are they called? The power thingies that give you energy regeneration, or the reactor core. If you get that one, it will be a great class to play, otherwise... Not so much. Wait, why am I not getting the energized stacks? Oh, they are killing the things before me. Great. So if you don't kill the things, you'll not have enough. No. This would be a very hard class to use. Now I see why they limited to one. Although, this is quite nice. Yeah, no. I think if you want to play this class properly, you have to start from the beginning without the Dio Striker, without the force field, and only start with the skills that you can actually use in the beginning all the time. Otherwise the debuffs will smash you for sure. Also this... Well, what? This doesn't cost mana when you activate it? Well, I guess it makes mana, energy. I guess it makes sense because it drains your energy. Okay, so I guess if you level it up to max, you get minus 6 energy regeneration, which will be enough for what? Almost 20 seconds. Okay. Depending, of course, on how many energy batteries you have or your rank, because your rank once per... You get one energy, max energy per rank. Which is not so bad.
A stroll nest has been located and should be destroyed.
I guess you can move with this thing around and get your... That's not a very smart idea. And get your energy stacks. No. Attacking. Also, this loads so slow. I wish you had a buff to load this thing faster. Can't really complain about the class itself or the decision they make. I mean, the developers are really good at their job. Okay, power cell. That's the thing I was looking for. So if you have a power cell with you, things will be a lot more easier. So yeah, you need to find a lot of blue orbs and you need to find a lot of power cells. I guess if the team feeds the Terminator the power cells, it will actually be fun. So, maximum stacks. Can you keep the stacks or do they go away as well? I think they're not permanent, of course. Okay, let's get some stacks over here. With a Deer Striker.
Good thing you were in the neighborhood. Stay safe out there.
And now we can actually activate it for a while. We can keep it activated, I mean. Yeah, the parcel is actually holding up a lot better.
Extraction point marked.
Oh, you need 20 stacks, but if you get 21 stacks you die. That means you have to be so precise to get the bonuses. Okay, this will be a very fun class. Terminator has killed himself. Agility exhaust. You do get some speed, so I guess I kind of see what they're going for, of course. Yeah, I guess this is not that bad if you don't use the secondary firing mode. Attacking. Oh, I should... Oh, the hellspawn is here. Yeah, they also buffed his artillery, so I guess he deals more damage right now. Attacking. Let's pretend we are roadrunners and run away. Yeah, this kill is actually very good with a very low cooldown. The other ones, well, not so good. The Vindicator still has the same problem. Very... very high cooldown before it shoots, so even if you... I guess you... I don't know. Maybe if they make it so that the first shot of the Vindicator is instant and then it triggers the cooldown, that would make more sense. Also, I think I should have looked over here, so let's see... target, move, switch... move to map location... middle mouse button. I never used that one before. What? Wait. What happened over here? So the hellspawn destroyed. Terminating. Yes, it destroyed the biomass. That's funny. So when it burrows like that, it destroys the biomass. Never knew about that one. Let's test it out again. Yeah, destroys the biomass. Oh, that okay. We have a mass... we have a weapon of mass biomass destruction. Mass biomass destruction. That's hilarious. Now, that's a very good skill. It doesn't cost a lot of energy. It does a lot of damage. So, we explode in 21 stacks. Follow me. Terminating. Engaging. Reloading. Attacking. Cover me. No. The Neo Striker is too dangerous. You have to use the other shield with that. And you'll get killed by the ranged units. That's the problem. Well, we almost made it out alive. Doesn't matter. I wasn't planning on getting out of the mission alive. Yeah, the Terminator class is very, very hard to play and to judge and to kind of read a bit. So definitely, Dio Striker is not going to take any prizes in my book. So what else generates the energy attacks? Nothing except this one. But this one has a very big cooldown. Cooldown is 70 seconds. These are basically useless. Because you need a lot of energy stacks to use them. Consumes energy stacks. Everything consumes the stacks, but only two skills produce it from what I can see. Actually, three skills, but I remember what the last one is. Surge. Surge also consumes that? Oh no, actually, XX, whatever this is called, generates stacks as well. ...40 seconds cooldown. Oh, okay, so this lowers my energy regen, but it doesn't lower it as much as the other, as the Dio Striker. I guess this is the only way you are supposed to play the game with XS whatever at a higher level, and the rest can stay the same. Combat agility exhaust. Yeah, this has been a fun learning experience. I guess I wanted to test out the Dio Striker a lot more, but apparently it's only meant for very niche builds, niche stuff, and I'm never a fan of those things, if you know me. So how do you stop this? Well, I guess you have to use... Okay, when you get 20 stacks, you have to use something over here to reduce the stacks. So if you consume the stacks, I'm not sure how much the passive buffs last. 10 seconds only. This is a lot of work. This unit requires a lot of micromanagement, to be honest. Also, we have two guards. I don't know why we have two guards. I mean, the autocannon and some other weapons would be better on him, like the minigun, but it seems like he's such a waste. He'll be extremely slow with a big gun like that. While with the ASV, at least it's 3.9. And he does a lot of damage, and then you have the plasma things. Will be damaged, so he does damage everything. I guess he's meant to have a lot of power cells, and he's also meant to use a lot of XCIS, and I don't know. It's fun. I'll have to learn more about him. See you next time. Bye.